Very good morning, dear students. This video is for class 10th, subject science, chapter number 11, The Human Eye and the Colorful World. And this is lecture number 2. The topics to be covered today are important terms used, accommodation power of eye, and defects of vision. Dear students, we all know that human eye is an autofocus camera. Why we are saying it as autofocus? Because the eye adjusts itself when it sees the nearby objects and far away objects or the distant objects. Here, there is no manual requirement of adjusting the focal length of the eye when we are seeing the object at different places. The eye adjusts itself to see the nearby object or the distant objects. That is why eye is called an autofocus camera. It is having the best quality of image formation. Now, do you think that the eye can see the objects at any distance? The answer is no. Why? Because the focal length of the lens, eye lens, can be adjusted only to a limit. And that is why the adjustability that an eye can make is limited. So here we have some terms related to the adjustability of the eye. The first term is the far point. When we see any object, we find, suppose we are seeing a distant tree which is at infinity distance from us, but we are able to see the tree clearly. So far point, it is the farthest point or the maximum distance up to which the eye can see clearly. Is called the far point. So this is the maximum distance up to which the normal human eye can see clearly. The second term is near point. What is near point? As the name suggests, that this is the minimum distance up to which the eye can see the objects comfortably. We can say that this is the closest point or the minimum distance up to which the eye can see clearly and comfortably without any strain on the eye. This is also called the least distance of distinct. Distinct means clearly vision. You might have found that when we bring the book that we are reading very close to our eyes, that time we are not able to read the book, or we are not able to read what is written on the book comfortably and distinctly. So, there should be a minimum distance for which the eye can adjust its focal length. That minimum distance is called the near point of the eye. For a normal human adult. Now, what do you mean by normal human adult? The person who do not require these specs to view the objects. So, for a normal human adult eye, the nearest point or the near point or the least distance of distinct vision is 25 centimeter and the far point is infinity. Because we can see the objects clearly without any strain till the infinite distance. So, in this way, this becomes the maximum distance or the farthest point up to which the eye can see clearly, and this becomes the minimum distance at which the eye is clearly able to see the objects. So, the range of vision is 25 centimeter to infinite distance. Range of vision, the range of the distance that an eye can see clearly. One another important term is persistence of vision. This term has not been mentioned in your NCERT, but I want to tell you about this term because we all know that the image formed on the retina of the eye is not permanent. What happens if it is not permanent, still it is not instantaneously removed from the retina as soon as we stop looking at the object. There is some time which is part of some seconds, or the time part of 1 second for which the image of an object remains on the retina even after the object is removed from the sight of the eye. So even after the removal of the object in from the front of the eye, still the image of that object remains on the retina for a very small time. And that time is called persistence of vision. We can also define persistence of the vision as the ability of the eye to retain the image for about 1/16th second. So the time is 1/16th of a second even after we have stopped seeing the object, and that ability is known as persistence of vision. This phenomena of persistence of vision is used in making the motion pictures that you call movies. What is done? Many number of pics, and for sure about 24 pics or images per second, they are moved in front of the eye, which makes the series of the images movable. When it happens, we see that the image is moving or some video is played. So this is how all the movies and videos are made on the basis of persistence of vision. The next important topic is accommodation power of eye. This is also called power of accommodation. So dear students, as we all know that in case of a lens, here we have a convex lens and the image formation with the help of this lens is on different places according to the position of the object in front of the lens. But in case of eye, we all know that the distance between the eye lens and the screen where the image is formed, which is retina. So the lens and the position of retina is fixed. So how the eye is adjusting itself for different places of the object so that it can make the image on the same plane. On the same place it is making the images of the object that it sees, whether the object is a nearby object or a distant object. So what the lens does, because this lens is flexible, along with the ciliary muscles, the lens can adjust its focal length. If the place where the image will be formed is fixed, the position of the lens is also fixed, but the object distance will not be fixed. Then what is that? That can be changed or adjusted to get the image on the same place. As we all know that with the help of lens formula, we have a formula 1 by f is equal to 1 by v minus 1 by u. So this is how the focal length of the lens, image distance and the object distance, these are interrelated with each other with the help of lens formula. If we are fixing up the position of the image, but if the object distance is varying, then what is left in the relation that can be adjusted to get the same image position? That is focal length. Focal length of the lens can be adjusted. So this ability of the eye lens to adjust its focal length is called the accommodation or adjustability. But how this accommodation is done in the eye? The lens adjust or accommodate its focal length with the help of ciliary muscles that hold the lens at its position. Now let us see how this is done. Now let us understand how the focal length of the lens is adjusted with the help of ciliary muscles. So let us take the case when the object is at infinite distance. So the light rays coming to the eye would be almost parallel. When the light strike to the cornea, they get refracted this way. But now if the lens do not adjust itself according to the focal length, because the curvature of the lens is more, so the focal length of the lens would be smaller. So the light will get converged nearby the lens like this. What the ciliary muscle do at this time when we are seeing a distant object? Ciliary muscles, they relax. So when they relax, they go back to their original place this way. So they are going back to their original place, which is called the process of relaxation. Ciliary muscles, they relax, and as they have hold the lens in this way, so when they are going back in their positions, they will make the lens thinner, and that's how the focal length, because the when the lens becomes thinner like this, then this curvature is very less, according to which the focal length will be larger than the first one. So the focal length of the lens changes, and now when the lens becomes thinner, the lens is now able to converge the light rays at the retina, and this is how the image formation takes place at retina. So the first process is ciliary muscles relax, lens becomes thin, focal length increases, and finally image of distant object is formed on retina. Now let's say the image of the nearby object is to be made. So the eyes, firstly, they are in relaxed mode, so the ciliary muscles, they are relaxed and the lens is thinner. But when the object is placed very nearby to the eye, then there is a need to change the focal length, because if the curvature of the lens remains the same for a nearby object, the light rays will converge even after the retina. So what happens if the lens is not changing its focal length? The light rays coming from a nearby point, they will get converged, and as the light rays are already diverged here, they will get a little amount of the light rays will be converged, and further when the focal length of the lens is larger, then the light rays will get converged beyond the retina. This is the case when the lens is not adjusted according to the distance of the object, but the eyes are very small. What they do? The ciliary muscles, they contract, they become lower in their positions, or you can say they loosen up the lens that they hold. So now the curvature of the lens becomes smaller. So the lens is now, earlier it was this kind, now it is this. How does this small curvature help us? It decreases the focal length of the lens. So this is helping us to make the image or to converge the light rays only on retina and not beyond that. So what is done here? The ciliary muscles contract, lens becomes thick, focal length decreases, and the image is formed on retina. This is how the lens changes its focal length with the help of ciliary muscles. This ability of the eye lens to change its focal length, change means increase or decrease, to change its focal length depending upon the distance of the object, this ability is known as accommodation power of the eye, or power of accommodation of eye. But always remember one thing, that there is a limit up to which the focal length can be adjusted, that is 25 centimeters to infinity distance. The focal length of the lens cannot be made smaller than a limited value. The next important topic is defects of vision. Dear students, although the eye is an architectural wonder, but most of the time, the normal vision of the eye gets affected due to the loss of accommodation or change in the structure of eye. So, the abnormalities in the normal vision because of the loss of accommodation or change in the structure, they are called defects of vision. These defects can be of various types. For example, the three main defects of the vision are myopia, hypermetropia, or presbyopia. Myopia is also known as nearsightedness. Hypermetropia, which is also called farsightedness, or hyperopia, it is also called hyperopia. Presbyopia, it is the defect of vision because of the aging of the person. As the person gets older, this defects come into play. Let us discuss the defects of vision in detail. The first defect is myopia or nearsightedness. As the name suggests, this is a defect in which a human eye can see nearby objects clearly, but the eye is not able to see the distant objects clearly. So, a human eye will be called as myopic if it can see the nearby objects clearly but unable to see the far off objects or distant objects clearly. What can be the reason behind this defect? So, the first reason can be excessive curvature of the eye lens. Second can be the elongation of eyeball. Now, what do we mean by elongation of eyeball? That means the size of eyeball increases, because of which even if the lens is adjusting properly, the position of the retina shifts a little behind than its actual position, because of which the lens is not able to form the image of the object on retina. First reason says that excessive curvature, that means the convergence ability of the lens is more, or the lens is thicker and it is not able to adjust its focal length while seeing the distant objects, because of which what happens? The light coming from the distant objects converges nearby the lens, and let's say if this is the retina, then convergence of the light rays just nearby the lens because of its excessive curvature, what happens? That the image formation do not take place on the retina, because of which that object is not clearly visible. Now, how can we correct the defect? If the eyeball size has become big or the excessive curvature of eye lens is a problem, then we can do one thing, we can increase the convergence, or you can say that the focal length of the lens can be increased. If not, because the changes in the focal length of the eye lens can only be done with the help of ciliary muscles. But as we are not able to do it by ourselves from the outer side, what we do, we use a concave lens which are there present in the specs that we use to properly maintain or to properly see the objects. So what do? We use a concave lens in front of the eye lens so that the light rays can be diverged a little more and then they will converge. So if this happens, the light ray will converge at a larger distance so that the retina will now, the photoreceptors on the retina, they will get activated when the light rays are converging at this point. So the image formation will take place. So how the correction can be made? Using a concave lens of suitable power. Let us first understand how a normal human eye works. I am making the retina, the cornea and the eye lens. So here the normal human eye works that the lens adjusts its focal length for the light rays coming from a nearby object, which is the which is present at the least distance of distinct vision, and from the light rays which are coming from the far away object. So first the light will get converged here, and then the rest of the convergence will be done on the eye lens. And how this lens adjusts itself or changes its focal length so that refracted light will only meet at the retina. So this is how the normal human eye functions. Now let us see how a myopic eye performs its functions. So as we all know that the object is refracting the light, the eye lens is adjusting its focal length properly when it sees a nearby object, but when it feels that the light rays are coming from very far away, then that time the focal length is not adjusted properly and the convergent light rays, they meet at a point before the retina so that the image formation do not take place on the retina and the object looks blur to us. So the objects at far away distance are not clear to the person having a myopia disease. Now that, what does it mean? That means that the far point or the farthest distance up to which a myopic eye can see clearly now is not infinity. It is somewhat less than infinity. It has been shifted, because of which it is happening. Now let us see how the correction can be done, because we know that the correction can be done using a concave lens. So here what happens, that all the light rays which will come from the far away object, because of using a concave lens of suitable power, what will happen, that they will get diverged this way, then they will enter the cornea and get converged a little, and now as the lens is not able to perfectly converge the light rays, so the light rays are already diverged, So, the lens will not be able to make the convergence at a nearby point. Now, the convergence will take place on the retina. Because for this, what is happening? That the light rays which are coming from the faraway point, it performs as the light rays coming from a nearby point, and for which this eye is perfectly working. So this is how the correction of a myopia disease is done. So whenever you have been asked about a disease, what the things you have to write? First, what is that defect? Or what is the problem in that defect? Then the cause of the defect. Then how the correction can be done, along with the three ray diagrams that I made it for you. One, the normal eye, then the myopic eye or the defect in the eye, and the last one for the correction. So now, as in this session, you will not be facing the questions coming in your exams, but make it clear that you get the concept clearly so that it will help you in the higher classes. So dear students, we have studied one defect today. Tomorrow we'll understand the another defects called hypermetropia, presbyopia, and we'll also study the further topics, that is refraction through a prism. So these are the topics that we are going to cover in the next lecture, that is lecture number 3. Now let us see today's homework. In today's homework, you have 3 questions which are in-text questions of your NCERT. Question number 1 is, what is meant by power of accommodation? Question number 2 is, a person with a myopic eye cannot see the object beyond 1.2 meter distinctly. What should be the type of corrective lens used to restore the proper vision? So you have to tell what kind of corrective lens should be used, concave or convex. Question number 3 is, what is the far point and near point of the human eye with normal vision? So these are the 3 in-text questions that you have to do in your FAIR notebook. Along with this, you also have to make the notes of the video lecture in your FAIR notebook. And as homework solutions of lecture 1, you were having 2 main questions. That first, you have to make the diagram of the human eye, and you have to label the diagram of the human eye. The second was that you have to write the 2 functions of each part of the eye. So dear students, let me show you the diagram of the eye that you have to make. So this is the diagram that you are supposed to make. It should have the cornea, which controls or converges the light, through which the light enters. And how is it? It is a transparent membrane over the eye. Then we have the iris. Iris controls and regulates the light of light that enters the eye. Then we have a hole in the central point of iris, which with the help of iris limits the amount of light entering into the eye. Then we have the lens, convex lens, which converges the light rays on the retina. Ciliary muscles, they held the lens in its position. The innermost layer of the eye is called retina, which performs as a screen. So the image formation takes place on retina, and what is its function? First, it behaves as a screen. Second, it is having the photoreceptors, which are rod cells and cone cells. They become active when the light falls on them, and they give an electrical signal to the optical nerve, which takes the signal from the retina to the brain. where the electrical signals are processed and an erect image is shown. Here we have a blind spot. Blind spot where no roads and consoles are present. Then we have the vitreous humor. It is transparent in nature so that the light can pass through it and that can converge on retina. The another function is that it can maintain the shape of the eyeball. Here also in this cavity we have a liquid called aqueous humor. This aqueous humor is containing the nutrition for the eye. So it does two things: maintains the fluid pressure of the eye. Second, it provides nutrition to the various parts of eye. So these are the functions of various parts of eye, and I have also shown the diagram that you have to make in as the answer of your first question. Okay, students. So I'll see you in the third lecture. Till then, take care and goodbye.